Hello, my name is Søren Gjesse, and I work on the Dart team. I want to show you why Dart is a great language for building applications for the cloud. Dart is a new platform for scalable web application engineering, and Dart runs in modern web browsers and on the server. This provides a great opportunity to build web applications using the same language for both client and server, and to utilize the services provided by the Google Cloud Platform. Today, I'd like to show you how easy it is to run your Dart code in Google's data centers. Use App Engine Managed VMs. Dart is now a supported language on App Engine. App Engine scales automatically as your application gets more and more popular. App Engine Managed VMs combine the power of App Engine with the flexibility of running on a general server. It lets you combine the total control of freedom of Compute Engine VMs with the auto-management capabilities of App Engine. Because you're running in a VM, you can install any additional software, and there are no restrictions on how the Dart server can use the machine. Even accessing your favorite C library using a native extension is possible. App Engine Managed VMs support local development. You develop and test locally, and when you're ready to deploy, the deployment process makes sure that the exact same code will run in the Google data center. To get started, you only need a few things. You need the Google Cloud SDK, which includes the dcloud command line tool. And you need the latest version of the Dart SDK and the Dart editor. The process is all well documented on the Dart website, dartlang.org. Getting started is easy. A basic HTTP server application is just a few lines of code. Import the Dart App Engine package, start the server application running, and handle HTTP requests as you already do with the Dart IO library. If you already have a server application written in Dart, moving it to App Engine only requires changing a few lines of code. You can run this code locally using the dcloud app run command. And when you're happy with your application, deploy it by just running the dcloud app deploy command. Besides providing an HTTP server, the App Engine package provides APIs to Google Cloud services. The initial set of APIs provided are for accessing Cloud Data Store, Memcache, Users API, and for logging. Let's look at the Cloud Data Store. The Google Cloud Data Store is a fully managed schemaless database for storing non-relational data. Being a schemaless database, it lets you store entities having a set of named properties. To give your app maximum flexibility, we provide two APIs. There's a low-level API, which allows you to work with data store entities directly as key value map. On top of this, we've added a mapping layer. This makes it possible to store concrete instances of Dart objects with just a few simple annotations to indicate how your instance properties should map to data store properties. Let me show you how simple it is to store an object into the data store. First, you need to model how the object is stored. Let's look at this simple person class. We want to store the two properties name and age. The class defines the properties and extends model. Then the actual description of how this object maps to the data store is described using a subclass of model description. Note, this defines the types used in the data store. It can also be used to define additional information, like whether the property is mandatory and whether it should be indexed in the data store. With this model description in place, the model class is annotated with the description and the class definitions are all set. Now, storing objects into the data store is as simple as creating a number of instances. Here we create two instances, George and Sarah. And then we call the data store commit method to actually store these instances into the data store. Here we use the Dart asynchronous programming model. The future return from commit completes when the commit operation has finished. If you're familiar with the App Engine Python NDB DataStore API, this probably looks familiar to you. Now, this is all open source. The code is developed on GitHub and is available as a Dart package using the Dart package manager pub.dartlang.org. Now, let's take advantage of code sharing. When you use Dart both in the client and on the server, your front end and back end can share code. This is great because this code only has to be written once. For example, take a client and server communicating using a JSON-based protocol. The associated data objects and serialization and deserialization code is needed on both sides. Having the objects used in the communication defined in a shared library ensures that both sides share the same code. There are many other advantages to sharing code on client and server, like not having to rewrite validation logic in different languages. With data on both client and server, this validation logic can be shared. How about the case where an application needs to work offline? In this case, large parts of the code that is running on the server needs to be available on the client. When using the same language on both client and server, this becomes easier. The code only needs to be written once and will always be in sync. These are simple examples. In your app, you can find even better uses of this. Well, this is just the beginning. We are going to evolve our data support for Google Cloud. On the API side, there are still a number of popular App Engine APIs missing, and we will be adding more of these. Another important thing we're working on is improving data access to Google Cloud services in general. Most services, like Google datastore, is available on most platforms. It's available on Google Compute Engine, it's available on your own server, on other cloud provider servers, and even in the browser. We will also be working on making the Google Cloud services available in all these platforms, making your Dart code equally valuable across platforms. With this information, I hope you're dying to get started developing your Dart application for Google Cloud. Visit dartlang.org to find more information on how to get started and start building your Dart application in the cloud today.